Hello, friends, and welcome back to r/ProRevenge. Today we have two brand new crazy revenge stories for you. Our first story about a daily routine of security officers, and of course a dose of revenge for you. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss a new video every single day. Client is many kind of ist. Boss isn't having it, gets one client fired, his replacement replaced. This happened a few weeks ago, and I'm still in awe of my boss who made it happen. I work as a private security officer for a small but well-respected company. The higher-ups are masters at getting contracted for big-name clients, and they treat us employees very well. We'd been subcontracted by a larger security firm to run event security for a certain tech company's event during a certain famous film festival. Some serious money was being thrown around to make this event happen. I was told $75,000 per day just to rent out the venue, $6 million worth of equipment. The list goes on. It was a big deal. Our client's representative, who we'll call Polly, was a New York native with a thick Brooklyn accent that wouldn't have been out of place on the set of The Sopranos. He'd been flown in from his base of operations just to oversee the event, and it soon became clear that he was going to cause problems. First off, the agreement between my firm and our client was to provide asset protection, meaning we were to make sure that none of the expensive yet highly portable electronic equipment went missing. Yet as soon as we got there, Polly decided to ignore all that and had us working the doors as glorified bouncers. All our previous instructions were to be ignored, and Polly was God. This had us pretty PO'd, as we'd picked our people with unobtrusive asset protection in mind, but whatever, we're professionals, we can roll with it. Secondly, Polly was an a-hole. Everything we did was wrong somehow, even when we did exactly what he wanted us to. We were doing it wrong. He'd berate the poor officer right in front of everyone. He'd change our instructions on a whim and get mad at us for not complying with the new instructions before everyone had a chance to be informed. Third, and arguably worst, Polly was an ist of every type. Racist, ageist, sexist, he was the worst. We brought in female officers and he'd inevitably stick them in the most out-of-the-way posts he could to make sure they didn't have to interact with the tech people. Same went with every officer Polly thought was over 35. Since we were working 12-hour shifts, we tried to rotate everybody through every post, but he'd take over the rotation and stick the old and female officers out of sight. It got to the point where we were seriously considering quitting the contract, and we never do that. Enter my boss. Let's call him Rick. Rick is ex-military, and his thing is, he gets crap done. Rick, like several of us, is a licensed private investigator as well as security officer. Rick is borderline OCD when it comes to keeping records. Rick has hidden cameras. Rick wore a wire and recorded a lot of Polly's crap. Then crap hit the fan when Rick passed off supervision of the site to me for a day and went to a meeting with the higher-ups from my company and a conference call with the higher-ups from Polly's company. Let's call them D's and A-Holes Inc., or DNA. The next afternoon, the A and DNA showed up and took Polly into one of the rooms the tech people had been using for demos earlier that day and spent over an hour yelling at him. One of our people, a female officer with 15 years of experience who'd worked security at the freaking Pentagon and who'd been shoved in a corner nevertheless, heard the whole thing going down as she was posted outside the door. According to her, Polly said several things, but one that stuck out was, "These guys are weak. They're bringing in freaking girls," before being told to shut the hell up. Polly was fired right there and escorted off the property. The next day, those of us who hadn't been there to see it were told the whole story, and we reveled in the fact that we wouldn't have to deal with Polly anymore. Morale, which had been at historically low levels, shot through the roof. This would be a good place to stop the story. But as the infomercials say, wait, there's more. A took over. Remember him? The A-hole in Dicks and A-Holes Incorporated? And he was worse. In different ways, he was just as bad as Polly, but he was much, much, much more subtle about it. And I can't stress this enough. He was an a-hole. He tried to get me fired for talking to the client, the tech company's people. The event was winding down at this point, and I'd asked the guy in charge of the tech people a question about continuing security needs. Turns out the tech company was taking their stuff out of the demo rooms and therefore wouldn't need those rooms secured anymore, so we didn't need an officer for that post anymore. A was livid that I had spoken to the client without his say-so and that I had cost us thousands by doing so, which was total bullcrap. A went to Rick and yelled at him about it too. Rick, however, had my back and just shrugged the whole thing off. This is going long, so I'll just sum it up. Rick was eventually forced to employ the same tactics that he'd used against Polly, and another conference call was made. Turns out DNA had been bought out by another company, and since A was a founder, he didn't get fired. But he did get sent home, and yet another guy from the bigger company was flown out to oversee the last few days. That guy was pretty cool, and we had no further problems. The icing on the cake is that the tech company had seen all the bullcrap my people had been put through and had been impressed with us. We've been asked to provide security services for their next event. Congratulations. That's the best icing on the cake, getting the a-holes kicked out while getting hired for even more events. And our next story. Your bad driving caused you not to get hired. Throwaway account because this just happened and I'm not sure if there'd be consequences for it. Background. I work for a construction company that has many divisions, but I work in the new construction section. I've been working at this company for about 5 years, but actually worked along with my dad, who had 30 plus years at the same company. Because of his long tenure in not only the field, but with the company, I got a lot of inside perks. I created a lot of very beneficial professional relationships through him. My dad recently became very sick, suffering from liver and throat cancer, stage 4, and had to stop coming to work. My dad and I were the only office guys in the department, so once he stepped away, I became number one guy in the department, making all the decisions. This detail will come into play later. The crime. I recently got engaged to the woman of my dreams. We had planned on getting married in 2018, but with my dad being sick and not sure how long he'll have, we moved it up to the fall of 2017. So we're getting all the wedding planning stuff done ASAP. This last weekend, February 11th and 12th, we conquered a lot of the list. The incident happened on the 11th. We just finished our registry and were about to meet our DJ at a local coffee shop, but had some time for lunch. We grabbed a quick meal before heading to our meeting. As I'm pulling up to the stop sign to leave the parking lot into the street, a car pulls in tight and cuts me off a good 10 feet before the stop sign off of the street. Now, usually I have horrible road rage. Fingers, cuss words, I've even thrown stuff from my car in fits of rage. My fiance hates my road rage, so I've tried to behave myself as much as possible when she's in the car. So when this guy cut me off, all I did was throw my hands in the air and a what the hell gesture. He was driving a Chrysler 300 with Illinois plates. Can't stand Illinois drivers. As I threw my hands, he slammed on his brakes, looked at me, rolled down his window and asked, "What's your deal?" I responded with, "You cut me off. Don't know how to take turns very well?" He responded with, "You want to get out of the car?" Yes. At this point, that's all my head was screaming. But when he asked this, my fiance grabbed my arm and said, "Please don't." So I looked at him and said, "Nope, I don't want to get out of the car. I want you to learn how to drive." His response was to call me the P word for listening to my B and drive off. He hit all my buttons in the matter of a minute. Bad driving, not apologizing, and disrespecting one of my loved ones. If she wasn't there in the car, there would have been a fight. I thought that was the end of me seeing that A hat, and I was not happy. But karma was on my side. The revenge. Since my dad left work, my responsibilities have doubled, and that caused me to stay later and even come in on weekends. My boss, seeing my struggle, asked if he could hire someone to help take some of the load off my desk. Since my dad leaving, I've pushed to have one of the field guys take over because they already know a lot about what's going on and wouldn't have to teach much to them. My boss didn't like that idea because he didn't want to lose one of our great field guys. He put some ads out to hire someone, but promised me I'd be a part of the hiring process and would even have the last word when hiring, since I'd be working with them a lot. Like Santa bringing you everything you asked for on Christmas morning, that A-hat that cut me off walked through the front door asking about the opening. He hadn't seen me yet, and being in the company car when I drive to and from work, he didn't see my car either. My boss took him to the conference room and asked the basic questions while I was finishing a bid we wanted to send out. Then came my chance. My boss called me on the speakerphone asking me to come back to finish the interview. I usually hate Mondays, but this felt like the greatest Monday I could ever have. Right when I walked in the room, the A-hat's eyes lit up, got real big. What made it even better is, as I was walking in, I hear my boss tell him that I'm coming to finish the interview and would be his boss, and we wanted to make sure it was a good fit. The interview went poorly, like really, really poorly. I barely roasted him with any difficult questions because he was so nervous slash freaked out that his answers to my questions were horrible. My boss then took me out to the hallway after I was done and asked what I thought. I told him the whole situation and said I could never work with him. That was all my boss needed, and said we'll keep looking for a new replacement. Best part is, I gotta tell the guy the news. I basically told him to get the F out and laughed in his face about trying to get a job here. Funniest part actually is, he told me he already had other job offers at some of my competitors and was just shopping around. Idiot actually named the competitors who he claimed to have offered him jobs. What he didn't know is that our company is actually really close and friendly with our competitors. I called up those companies and told them what happened, and they not only told me they didn't offer him jobs, but now they definitely won't. What can I say? His crappy attitude caused him not to get hired. Hey guys, thank you all for watching the video to the end, and I'll see you in the next one.